Hello once again.
Any progress on that matter we discussed? Ah, Miss Holcomb. How rare to see you out. And with a complete stranger. Curious.
This here's Vicar DeSoto. He's always offering spiritual counsel to those that need it.
Thank you for the kind assessment, Miss Holcomb.
We've met.
I admit, I've been quite interested to make our outsider's acquaintance.
You've already made my acquaintance. I haven't found the book yet. I haven't left town.
Please get it.
Of course. But I had something I wanted to ask you.
What would you like to discuss?
Parvati wanted to talk to you about what Reed asked us to do.
But what? I thought you would talk to him.
You wanted to speak to me, Ms. Holcomb? Every time I've tried to engage you in conversation, you look at the floor, answer in single words, and slink away. I can't imagine what would be so grave as to drive her to my mission. What has Mr. Thompson asked you to do?
Cut off the power to Adelaide's deserters.
Depriving them of safety from the marauders and wildlife.
Exactly.
I can see why that troubles you. Miss Holcomb has a soft heart. Always has, if you believe the talk.
What do you think of Adelaide's group, Vicar?
They rejected the order of society and live beyond the walls so thoughtfully provided by our Spacer's Choice patrons. Does that strike you as a responsible life choice?
Depends on how well the leader can provide beyond your walls.
Astute. But I am here, not in the deserter camp. So that's not a variable I can account for.
So what do you advise?
Assuming your goal is to save as many as possible, then you should bring everyone together. Send the power to Edgewater and convince the deserters to return to the fold.
I spoke to the deserters. They have some disagreement about the town's leadership.
No doubt. But order is the nature of our universe. Some lead, others must follow. You might as well complain about the gravity being too high. They who are not satisfied with their work are satisfied with nothing. What would you like to discuss?
Something you need?
You mentioned something you know what? Away from this guy. Farther away.
Something you need?
You mentioned something earlier that I wanted to ask you about.
You mean about the mission being too clean?
Isn't it supposed to be clean? It's a church.
I know, but Vicar says the universe is a machine, that it runs by law. Real machines have gunked up oil, scratches, and worn bits. You can tell they've seen handling, been used by folk. The machine Vicar sees is one that ain't never been run. It's not for people to live in. It's something on a museum shelf, under glass.
Then why did you want to talk to him?
The Vicar's about the only soul in the Vale who spends his time thinking on what is and ain't right. It's just that when he looks at me, I feel I disappoint him.
Hmm.
Yeah, huh?
Let's have an option to ask him or tell him anything else.
Any progress on that matter we discussed? Please get it. What would you like to discuss?
Alright, never mind. Alright. Okay, let's return to... this guy. I forget his name. Starts with an L.
I was little, we'd get freighters in every Sunday noon. Now they only come but once a month. I love the wind here.
Well, it's just outside of town. Ludwig!
Bring us honor, soldier.
You won't have to worry about that scout anymore.
You beat that scout to scrap with its own legs? Pulled its optic cables out its headcase?
Not exactly.
Actually, don't tell me. Rather use my imagination. You're a passing fair soldier, I will confess. But you are one. And the enemy is legion. What you need is an equalizer. A weapon to strike fear in their cold, mechanical hearts. Cantina, lavatory. Behind one of the toilets. That's where I've kept it hidden all these years.
You hid your secret weapon in a lavatory?
Sharp, ain't it? The lavatory is the very last place a mechanical has need to enter.
I'll let you know if I find it.
On the double, soldier. Don't want the bartender poking around in there with a mop.
Then you shouldn't have put it in there.
Go on.
Find Ludwig's secret weapon. Ludwig revealed that he's tucked away a secret weapon in Edgewater to be used in the event of a mechanical uprising. He's decided to entrust the weapon to you to aid in the crusade. The weapon should be in the bathroom of Edgewater's cantina. Well, we've been there. We can just go back there. I don't know why you have to hold a button down so you don't accidentally enter a town. That's kind of weird. The hell was that? Cantina?
Been eating nothing but salt tuna for a year.
Don't let the boss catch you saying that.
Well, it's true, though.
You're not a big drinker, are you?
No, you heard the guy. We gotta go into the bathroom here. Sealed bundle. A curious bundle discovered near a latrine in the Edgewater Cantina. A note reads, "If found, please return to Ludwig Miller at the landing pad. Thanks." Abernathy's grave site. Administrative passcode allowing access into the Emerald Vale geothermal facility. Alright. Nope, not a big drinker. This isn't the way to the...
Wish we had some better rations.
You know, it's telling me not that she's 20 whatever meters away. That's the number to the exit of this place. Yeah, it's here. Just Just a little running back and forth.
Bring us honor, soldier.
And that package you mentioned.
Feast your eyes, soldier. This here is a genuine Spacer's Choice injury customizing unit. Designed to deliver a lethal blast of electrical discharge. I call it the Hand of the Law.
Really?
You ever want to see a mechanical flailing around like a grounded fish?
Back
you
to
stick
that.
A couple thousand volts in its guts. With compliments from old Ludwig.
How do I use this injury customizing unit exactly?
There's a workbench right through this door. Attach that unit to your favorite weapon and go forth into glorious battle. Time's come for you to journey down into the black heart of the enemy's camp. I'm talking about the old geothermal plant.
Oh boy.
Unfortunately, the old plant lies outside my board-given jurisdiction. You'll need to get a passcode from the boss, Reed Thompson.
Don't worry about that. I've already got a password from Reed.
I've been after a passcode for years. Boss said no on account of my gross incompetence with all matters related to security. I need you to get us the brain of a mechanical. Well, not exactly a brain. Anatomically speaking, what we're looking for is a logic module.
How am I supposed to get one of these logic modules?
There's the rub. If a mechanical breaks down, the logic module fries. So you can't rip one out of its corpse. You're gonna have to find an intact model somehow.
Parvati, is a logic module something you could help with?
I don't reckon so. I work with gears and pistons and such. Stuff you can put hands to. Computers and mechanical brains are outside my ken.
You know, she names the mechanicals she fixes. Calls them Bess and Clancy and so on. Keep a careful eye on her. Could be a sympathizer.
What are you planning?
Don't tell anyone, all right? I've got a contact. A real expert in the inner workings of the automaton. We are gonna rip those mechanical secrets right out of their circuits.
Edgewater's in the middle of nowhere. You don't have a contact.
Well, excuse me. What I meant was I'm going to get a contact. Didn't know I had to be all prissy about my grammar around you.
There's a big difference between having a contact and going to get or try to get a contact.
If you die horribly, I will pour out a can of zero-G to your memory.
That's very reassuring.
Go on.
I'll let you be. Retrieve a logic module. The geothermal plant in the northwest portion of the region has been taken over by automechanicals. Ludwig wants you to infiltrate the plant and retrieve a logic module from one of the automechanicals there. Well, we need to go back to Silas. Can I fast forward to the graveyard? No. I have to go out one of the other gates. I mean, I can fast travel to Edgewater itself, but it is right here. The enemy. Is it right ahead? Well, from here, it would be to the left. Well,
if you're falling sick, I don't want you near me.
Hopefully this is the way I want to go. Looks like it. Yo, Silas.
Hey, Miss Parvati. Come for a visit? Lovely to see you about, Miss Parvati.
Things going all right, Silas?
Been keeping him careful and true, miss.
You talking about Silas?
Best to ask her yourself.
My dad's buried here. Silas watches over him when I can't leave the house.
I'm sorry, Parvati.
Oh. Well, thanks.
Something I can do for you?
You're surprised I said that. Yeah, we read his logs. All about how she came here as a baby. The mother was reassigned to a different world, different planet, and she, for whatever reason, she couldn't bring her with her. Yeah, about those fees you wanted.
You run into any trouble?
Conrad says he can't afford to pay.
Conrad's barbershop is a yawning pit that swallows his every bit. I keep telling him he should cut a few corners, skimp out on the disinfectant. You gotta put the squeeze on Conrad. Find some dirt on him. Maybe check his back room.
You suggesting extortion?
That's the word, extortion. Been on the tip of my tongue all day.
Okay, he just admits to it. I'll take a look. Can I ask him any other questions, actually?
Something I can do for you? Yeah?
I don't want to insult the guy. Oof. Extortion. Well, if the guy really doesn't have the money... What's that? Maybe he could pay. But it would make things difficult for him. Now I'm trying to remember where the barber shop is.
Sometimes I wonder what I'm doing with myself.
At least you got your health.
That on my way through. I can't, like, select one of these to track this. Then it would lead me right to the barbershop. But
what can I do for you?
Sound like you've had some training. I know a thing or two about medicine. You just recently leveled that up.
Oh? Am I in the company of a fellow doctor?
Only if I use the term doctor loosely.
I am a Spacer's Choice certified surgeon, and if you must know, I can stitch a severed thumb with a 58% chance of avoiding gangrene. Go ahead. What can I do for you?
Extortion. Got it. Oh, I'm thinking this wasn't here before. Letter from Phyllis. Conrad, receptionist shot himself. This is bad. Company's going to have to call it for what it is. Destruction of Spacer's Choice property. Eugene was an asset, and somebody has to pay his body price. This is going to ruin us, so I was thinking that we pawn off his teeth. Eugene had a full set of gold teeth. Heirlooms passed down his family or something. What? Wait, a full set of gold teeth in his mouth? That were heirlooms. You're processing his body, right? Just dig around and pry them out. Yeah, they're in him, but somehow heirlooms. Imagine wearing your father's gold teeth or something. We sell the teeth somewhere nice and proper, use the bits to pay his body price, and nobody's the wiser. What do you think? Don't write back. In fact, don't talk to me at all. Just give me a special signal next time you see me. Waggle your eyebrows. Phyllis G. You found a note from Phyllis to Conrad. Perhaps you could use the information from it to convince Conrad to pay his gravesite fees. Perhaps.
What can I do for you?
Persuade only one. I know about Eugene. Why not use his teeth as collateral for your gravesite fees?
You know about Eugene? How?
I'm a mind reader.
You were probably poking around my things. I really shouldn't leave my letters sitting out in the open.
But late for that.
Eugene's golden teeth were a family heirloom, representing three generations of poor dental hygiene. He took them to his grave.
I'm sure he won't miss them.
That's unthinkable. Eugene's body, and all rare earth minerals contained therein, are solely the property of Spacer's Choice. I can't ask Silas to dig up a man's body and pry a few teeth loose from his jaw just to pay my bills? Can I?
Are you asking rhetorically? Because if you're being serious... Ugh, gross.
Desperate measures, Miss Holcomb. Desperate measures. I'm going to have to ask Silas to dig up those teeth.
That was quick.
It's the only way I'm paying my gravesite fees.
You seemed totally against it a few sentences ago. Are you sure about this?
I'm sure that I have no other choice. Here you are. Gravesite papers affixed with my signature and an IOU.
Sweet. I'm told Eugene killed himself. What happened?
Eugene was not a suicide. He put a bullet in his brain, yes, but that's largely a technicality.
What?
I was the one who prepared Eugene's body for interment. I discovered symptoms of the plague on his corpse, and I discovered medicine in his pocket. Lots of medicine. Eugene overdosed on adrenatime, which is known to cause psychosis and paranoia as possible side effects. The paranoia drove him to take his own life.
That's horrible.
It's a miracle of bureaucracy. If Eugene's death were filed as a suicide, we'd all pay the price for his crime. We can all thank our lucky stars that young Eugene was hopped up on medication and suffered its predictable side effect. I included it all in my official report. I'd like to think I saved Edgewater a great deal of money. We never could have paid the fines associated with a suicide.
Wow.
What can I do for you? Go ahead.
Yeah, huh?
You mentioned something earlier that I wanted to ask you about.
In the bar? when I asked if you were a drinker?
Yeah, you sounded worried.
Sorry. I know, it's none of my business.
I'm going to guess you're not a drinker yourself.
Strong drink makes me sick. And it makes me real sad. I start thinking about things I oughtn't, and then... Well, never mind that. You got better things to think on. Sorry.
Well, alcohol is a depressant. But if you want to talk about it, I'm happy to listen.
I'm sorry. I shouldn't have said anything.
Mm-hmm.
Something you need?
I noticed you mention your dad a lot, but never your mother.
That's on account of how I never met her.
You mean she's dead?
I don't rightly know. She was in another division of the Spacer's Choice family. She worked in the Vale a few months, sorting the cannery computers. Her contract said any kids she had, expected or not, belonged to her office from the time of conception. So when I was born, I got sent here.
Oh. Is that normal?
Well, I don't know about normal. Dad said she worked under some kind of special contract.
That is horrible.
It's sensible. Dad just fixed machines. She did some kind of crazy math, high-level stuff. Better to raise me on his time than hers.
Well, that's... possible, but... Alright, so we can return back to Silas once again.
If you're falling sick, I don't want you near me.
Wait, that's to the landing pad. He's this way. Don't put these things in the way. I guess I get to hold that down. This isn't where I wanted to be. That's horrible. She's eating the thing looking at another live one. And so it's not this way. Cemetery. So I guess we're here? So if we're here, then I'm making a right. Because unfortunately, I can't fast travel to.
Been eating nothing but salt tuna for a year.
Yeah, I can't. Yeah, I think this is it. I can't fast travel to the cemetery. Terribly inconvenient. There we go. Good news, Silas. Let me just see what it says. You found a note from Phyllis to Conrad. Perhaps you can use the information. Blah, blah, blah. Okay, it doesn't say anything new. But it will in a minute.
Something I can do for you?
We need to talk about Eugene.
Yeah? What about him?
You first. I know you buried him.
Well, yeah. It's what I'm contractually obligated to do. What's this about?
I'm telling him to pull him out. I don't know if that's the angle I want to approach this.
Something I can do for you?
About those fees you wanted.
You run into any trouble?
I'm all done. Paperwork, fees, and signatures.
Reliable work from a freelancer. That's gonna take some getting used to.
I went out of my way for you.
And I'll buy you a drink sometime.
I was hoping for something more tangible.
Suppose you've earned it. One good turn deserves another.
Nice. Just get 450 bit cartridges. Abernathy was trying to hide his own illness. Persuade you, sweet.
Abernathy was sick? With the plague? That's disgusting. I shook hands with the guy.
Yeah. Why you wanted me to collect his fees?
I needed his fees because of his name. A, for Abernathy. He was at the top of my list, you see?
Hmm.
Yeah?
Done. We got some completed quests. We got this thing in a small cave somewhere. Frightened engineer. Yeah, we need one more volume. I can return to him with the other two books. Deliver Reed's message.
Something you need?
Okay. Well, stay tuned for next time, guys, when we return to the botanical town, settlement, whatever you want to call it. Deliver Reed's message and see what we can do. We need to find... We've got to have something... There's got to be a better way. We don't want to take power away from this town. And we don't want to take power away from these people. Maybe they will return. I don't want to threaten them, and I don't want to take their power away and leave them just, yeah, indefensible. So, hopefully we can find another way around this. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode, and always, seek adventure.